Okay, so this is video 17. So we will see the condition renal abscess. So renal abscess is a collection of pus around the kidney. So when there is a pus collection around the kidney, we call that to be renal abscess. So pus is formed following infection of soft tissue around kidney or infection of peripheral kidney tissue. So we see that there is an infection of the soft tissue of the kidney, which is around the kidney, or infection of the peripheral kidney tissue. So renal abscess is an unknown, uncommon disease caused by trauma and infection associated with kidney stone. So we see that it is because of any common, it is not very common disease, but which can be caused because of the trauma and infection which is associated with kidney stone. Next, in this article, we will discuss in detail about the causes, symptoms and treatment of renal abscess. So we will be seeing the various, associated conditions. Okay, that is related to renal abscess. So now in the diagram, you can see how a normal kidney is and renal abscess, a macro abscess, renal abscess diagram is given. So you can see that. So what are the various causes of renal abscess? It can be because of urinary tract infection. So which is the infection of the urethra, bladder and urethra. It may cause into spread into kidney, causing polyonephritis and kidney abscess. Polyonephritis, already we have dealt with that. Okay. So here, so we see UTI can actually, because of the infection that is there in the ureter, bladder, urethra, which can lead to polynephritis, or it can also lead to kidney abscess. Then bacteremia, distant infection such as pneumonia, if a person is suffering with pneumonia or peritonitis which spreads into the blood, then this bacteria spreads through the blood, right, into the kidney, and arterial blood carries bacteria into kidney tissue and causes polyonephritis or focal kidney abscess. So in case if the patient has got bacteremia or sepsis, if the bacteria is present in the blood, automatically what happens, it reaches the kidney, leading to polynephritis or focal, okay, in a particular point, okay, there is a renal abscess. Mycoplasma infection, so peripheral or kidney abscesses caused by Mycoplasma hominis. So this is the causative factor is observed following kidney transplant. So if there is an infection of Mycoplasma hominis after renal transplant, then we call that to be Mycoplasma infection. Then urinary tract stone. So already we have seen, like, urinary stone causes this abscess. So it can cause damage of ureter which follows infection. So the stone actually leads to damage to the ureter, which causes infection. So infection, it spreads into kidney, it causes kidney abscess. Okay, then vesico-ureteral reflex. Already we have seen this condition. So in normal situation, contraction of urinary bladder causes flow of urine into urethra. Okay, so occasionally in few patient urine flows. So in this condition, we see that there is a backflow of the urine into the ureter and kidney. So bacterial colony from urinary bladder spreads into kidney. Okay, so that is vesico-ureteral reflux. So with backflow of the urine, so again it can lead to infection which reaches the kidney, and it leads to formation of the abscess in the kidney. Then kidney inflammation, it creates the condition for kidney infection. Kidney infection results in kidney abscess. Intravenous drug abuse, neurogenic bladder. Okay, so these are the various causes again which can lead to renal abscess. So we have seen that urinary tract infection, bacteremia, mycoplasma infection, urinary tract stone, vesico-ureteral reflux and kidney inflammation. Next we will see people who are at high risk in developing renal abscess. So diabetes patient, pregnancy mothers, elderly patient 65 years and above, sickle cell anemia disease, autoimmune disease. Okay, people who are having all these are prone to develop renal abscess. Then symptoms, again here we see non-specific symptoms of renal abscess. So non-specific, we do not know. Generally we see the patient will have discomfort, we will not know why, the patient will not know why, and then the patient will also have weight loss here. Then specific symptoms of renal abscess, so the patient will be having fever with chills, then uncontrollable shaking or shivering will be seen. That is because of the temperature, which can be 102. Okay, so 102 to 104 degree Fahrenheit. So the person, because of high fever, okay, they will having shivering. Okay, rigor will be there, and then excessive sweating will be there in the patient. So these are the specific symptoms that we can see, fever with chills. So when we say fever, it is of high fever, which is from 102 degree to 104. So automatically there will be shivering and shaking. Then abdominal pain will be there. Then painful urination will be there in the patient. Bloody urine will be there. Hypotension, pale skin, tachycardia. Okay, so these are all the various symptoms of the patient suffering with renal abscess. Next diagnosis, if you see, patient will have history collection, physical examination, then urine examination, we will be able to see that there is hematuria, that is blood in the urine, then proteinuria, protein will be found in the urine, then urine bacterial culture, so bacteria are cultured from urine sample. Okay, and then blood examination, when we see hemoglobin, decreased hemoglobin is a sign of anemia, then complete blood count. So we can see that the patient will have increased WBC. Okay, white blood cell count will be there. Then blood culture has to be done for the patient. Then X-ray findings. So radiopaque shadow observed around kidney in abscess is large. We can see. Then again in ultrasound, we will be able to see kidney. Abscess is observed around the kidney. A diagnostic finding is large. Perirenal abscess, size of kidney is enlarged, suggested possible renal abscess. And CT and MRI also is done. So when we say history collection, we have to collect history collection. Okay, find out pain, since when it is there, physical examination, we can just, you know, see where the pain is, in, if it is, you know, under the flank. Okay, and then again checking of the vital signs, see, checking if the patient has got fever. Okay, then checking the blood pressure, because the patient is prone to develop hypotension. We can see for pale sign. When you're checking the vital sign, we will know tachycardia. Okay, so painful maturation. Okay, so abdominal pain can be assessed. Then we can do the urine examination. So we can check hematuria, if there is presence of blood in the urine or protein in the urine. Then culture has to be sent to see if there is, you know, any infection or any bacteria that is found in the urine. Then again blood, we'll have to do the hemoglobin, because hemorrhage, blood in the urine. So we'll have to check if there is anemia. And then CBC, when we do, we will know if the platelets is increased. Again ESR will be increased, and blood culture should be done. X-ray findings, we will be able to find if the abscess is there. Okay, so USG also helps in that. And then you have CT and MRI. So as I told you, CT and MRI, so these are again differentiate the intrarenal, that is the inside kidney tissue, and extra kidney tissue, we will be able to see if there is presence of abscess. Okay, then talking about management. So when we talk about the management here, treatment options for renal abscess includes the following. So we have to give all this following treatment, that is antibiotic should be given. So oral antibiotic should be given through the intravenous, that is the IV, it should be given. Then for hypertension, we have to treat them with AC inhibitors. Then for diabetes patient, we have to give metformin or insulin, or whichever drug they are taking, like Danorum, Yem. Okay, so whatever has been diagnosed by the doctor to them. Then percutaneous drainage, abscess is drained from outside and catheter is left for continuous drain and kidney injection of antibiotics. So continuous drainage also can be maintained. Then we have to give antibiotics so that the patient will be free from infection. Okay, so these are all the various management. So antibiotics, if hypertension, that has to be treated. Diabetic patient, we have to treat with the anti-diabetic drugs, and percutaneous drainage has to be done. Then carrying on with the nursing management. So when we talk about nursing management, we have to maintain fluid and electrolyte balance. So assess first, you know, assess the condition of the patient, monitor vital signs. Then we have to make sure that we are maintaining adequate fluid and electrolyte balance. So how do we maintain fluid and electrolyte? We have to assess fluid status of the patient. We have to limit fluid intake and prescribed volume. Then we have to check weight of the patient daily, maintain intake and output chart. Then maintain adequate nutrition. Assess nutritional status, check the weight of the patient, assess patient's nutritional dietary pattern, or how, you know, the meals that they eat, you know, the pattern, you know, how much of, you know, balanced diet they are taking. Okay, so protein, okay, how much they are taking, everything. With the dietitian, we have to prepare a menu plan, provide patients food preferences with dietary restriction, promote intake of high biologic value protein foods. Example, we have to ask them to take eggs, dairy products, meat should be given. Then we have to encourage high calorie, high protein, low sodium, low potassium snack between meals. This has to be provided to the patient. Okay, then talking about educate the patient and family, provide explanation of renal function, disease process, treatment options. So we have to provide explanation to the patient about their disease, okay, so about their disease process, their treatment options. Then we have to provide oral and written information as appropriate about medication, fluid and dietary restrictions. Very important, we have to tell them which are the drugs, when all to be taken, any drug before the food or, you know, after the food, okay, that has to be explained to them. We have to teach them about the side effects, adverse effects, okay, of the medication and signs of complication. So if anything, they have to report immediately. Then we should also tell them to maintain fluid balance. Whatever is prescribed, you should tell them, okay. So this is for every renal condition patient, disorder patient, we have to tell them, because sometimes they cannot overload. If the kidney is not able to function, then again it will lead to complications. So tell them they have to adhere to the, you know, amount of liter that is being prescribed to them, and the diet, whether it is protein restriction, okay, so how much of protein per day they should take, sodium, okay, all these are very important. And give the menu and tell them what all is expected to eat and what they should avoid, which is very, very important. And also tell them, because this is all in the education of the family, any query they have to call to the hospital, or they can give a visit once when the patient is having, you know, severe complication, okay. Then we have to explain about dialysis purposes, precaution, etc. So if the kidney is not able to function, the last thing that they will try is dialysis. So regarding dialysis also, we will have to tell the patient, okay. So they should have general idea, not that because of this, you know, they will have to undergo, but then we have to give them a general idea of it. So this is all about renal abscess. So in this video we have seen what is renal abscess, okay, and diagram is given there, the definition, the various causes. So under that we have seen 6 causes. Then what are the risk factors, who are under risk, that we have seen. Then symptoms. So symptoms mainly is based on non-specific symptoms and specific symptoms, and the diagnosis that the patient has to undergo. And then, so under diagnosis again, we have seen very elaborately history collection, physical examination, urine examination, blood examination, X-ray finding, ultrasound, CT and MRI. Then treatment again, antibiotics for hypertensive, for diabetic, then percutaneous drainage. Then nursing management, so assess the condition of the patient. So you will have to formulate the nursing diagnosis based upon the symptoms that the patient has got or the clinical manifestation. So we have to maintain fluid and intake chart, maintain adequate nutrition for the patient, and educate the patient and family. Okay, so with this we are finishing with the disease, that is renal abscess. So next class we will see other conditions.